All-Star Wrestling. This is Vince McMahon here at ringside, along with Pat Patterson. In the ring at the moment is Dominic DiNucci. And Dominic getting set to square off against a tremendous competitor in every respect from Mongolia, Killer Khan.
Well, Vince, for a man that doesn't know how to write, for a man that doesn't know how to read, he sure knows what to do in the ring. And this match should be very, very interesting to watch.
We'll have scheduled on the card all kind of activity here, but we'll get right back to the opening match with DiNucci against Khan as we continue in a moment.
Greetings, wrestling fans. Welcome to another action-packed card of All-Star Wrestling, promoted by Phil Zacco. These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. Chief deputies in attendance are Billy Longo and Peter Lash. Timekeeper at the bell, Mike Mittman. The attending physician is Dr. John Woods. The referees assigned by the State Athletic Commission, Danny Davis, Dick Worley, John Stanley, Gilberto Roman, and I'm your ring announcer for All-Star Wrestling, Gary Michael Capetta. The first match in the ring is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager, the Hollywood fashion plate, Classy Fred Blassie. And his protege from Mongolia, weighing 302 pounds, Killer Khan. And his opponent from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 257 pounds, Dominic DiNucci.
Dominic DiNucci against Killer Khan. We're set for the action to begin. Khan all over Dominic DiNucci. Khan regarded as one of the most vicious individuals to ever step foot in the square circle.
Well, Vince, I'll tell you, for a big man who weighs over 300 pounds, he is in fantastic condition. He could just go and go and go and nothing will stop him.
Khan with all sorts of physical gifts, one of them being perhaps the greatest balance of anybody in the World Wrestling Federation today. Unbelievable balance, and I guess that really he gets that from his sumo background, wouldn't you say, Pat?
Definitely, Vince. And he's still training as he was training years ago as a sumo, and he still does all these exercises that are very valuable to him. So this is why he keeps himself in such a great condition. All these different type of exercise that nobody else does.
That's a very unusual hold.
He looks like he's putting the pressure on the, I can't see on the chin. He's not choking.
He's close to a choke. Oh, the knee striking the head of Khan. But he hangs on.
But I tell you, you look at him on a screen, he looks big, but I'll tell you what, when you see him in person and you stand next to him, he is a big man.
Not exactly the most handsome man you'd ever want to meet.
I don't think he'll ever win any beauty contest, that's for sure.
Count of one, count of two. Khan, the master of martial arts, and apparently knows all of it. Again, a kick to the head by Dominic. Khan knows right where all the pressure points are, and apparently that's right where he has Dominic. Dominic's having a tough time with him.
He sure is. I'm surprised that Khan is so tough. You know, also Dominic DiNucci, for a big man, 275, 280. He's pretty agile in the ring, I'll tell you. Well experienced.
Dominic has gone by that little ponytail. Oh, a nice right uppercut. Clips him across the jaw. Dominic hanging on to that hair. Now right hand right on the end of the nose.
I've never seen that kind of a hole, Vince. Look at that stretching, the muscles.
And look at the size of the hands, Pat, on this man, this Killer Khan. Huge hands. Dominic has him again.
Now, Dominic is choking Khan with the rope.
Freddie Plaster getting a shot in the midsection of Dominic DiNucci. Dominic really unloaded on that one. Khan returning in like fashion.
Vince, Killer Khan is the type of man with that kind of a training that he has taken over the years can take a lot of punishment.
Dominic trying to get his dander up. Double thrust. Dominic. Oh, yes, sir. But he can't knock the big man down. Dominic, I believe, listed at 258 by the ring announcer, and Dominic can let you have it, but when he can't knock a man like Khan down, you know Khan is tough. Look at that.
Now, Vince, those kind of chops, it was one after the other. That's what they usually do in sumo wrestling. These guys are trying to push each other out of the circle, and they really chop each other one after the other like that. And that's exactly what he was doing.
Again, that sneaky Blassie up there behind Dominic DiNucci.
But it's not fair. DiNucci is actually in the ring fighting two men.
Dominic took a pretty nasty fall out there on the far side.
Looks like he hit his head on the side of the apron, Vince. If he did, he's going to be in trouble.
Dominic probably counted out.
It looks to me like as Dominic was thrown out of the ring, as he fell out of the ring, hit his head on the side of the apron and kind of knocked him loose for a while and he could not get back in the ring on time.
Wrestling fans, after 7 minutes, 41 seconds, Dominic DiNucci counted out of the ring, your winner, Killer Khan. This next match is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Japan, weighing 240 pounds, Yoshiaki Yatsu. And his opponent to my left, from Paulsboro, New Jersey, weighing 253 pounds, Pretty Boy Larry Sharp.
The Pretty Boy, Larry Sharp, against Yoshiaki Yatsu. Here we go. Nice exchange there, except that there underneath the rope, Yatsu getting the worst of it at the moment. No clean break on the part of Larry Sharp.
Vince, we just saw some beautiful display of amateur wrestling, which Yatsu is the best amateur wrestler.
Nice takedown. Question of which individual took the other down.
I was saying, Vince, Yatsu, one of the best amateur wrestlers to ever come out of Japan. And Larry Sharp also is a good amateur wrestler, so this should be very, very exciting to watch.
Yatsu winding up Larry Sharp. The second time they've met, to my knowledge. About a month ago, I guess it was, Pat, they met.
Yes, I remember it very well, Vince, and it was a very, very good match, very exciting. Yatsu, a young man, only 24 years old, and only been wrestling professionally for 3.5 months, and Vince, he has not lost a match yet, and he's been doing very, very well, and already becoming very, very popular right here in the United States.
Yatsu had hopes of representing his country in the previous Olympics. Of course, Japan as well as the United States boycotting. Unfortunate for some of the would-be athletes in those countries that boycott the Olympics.
You know, Vince, he really is an idol in Japan, that Yatsu is, as far as amateur wrestling. Now, he came over here to this country to become a professional wrestler. And now in Japan, everyone is awaiting his arrival. Whenever he feels he's ready to go back to Japan, he will go back, and I'll guarantee you, everybody will be out to see him.
Larry Sharp picking up the aggressive tactics a bit more than we saw earlier. We've said many times before how underrated Larry Sharp is.
Very true, Vince. Very underrated. He really knows what to do in that ring. He can really get down and dirty and vicious if he wants to. And Larry Sharp does have a great ability of amateur wrestling.
Pick up by Yatsu. Good-sized fella, Yatsu. Nice takedown. Very cleverly done.
Look at how he's pulling that leg, Vince. We'll try to turn him over.
Oh, look how he went high on him. Got a little off balance there. Nice reversal on the part of Larry Sharp. Knee to the chest area by Sharp. Breaking those places across the facial area.
You know, Yatsu is going to have to learn that, you know, in amateur wrestling, you don't really break the rules, but in professional wrestling, a lot of times some of these wrestlers just look to go out there and really break the rules, and he's going to have to learn that if he wants to be successful, he's going to have to fight fire with fire, and so far he's been doing pretty well.
Sharp ramming a knee to the back of the head. Yatsu certainly has been able to demonstrate, Pat, that he can certainly take the physical abuse, and that's certainly a sign of a contender. Oh, right in the head.
That will give you a headache for a few days, I'll guarantee you. I was going to say, you can see on Yatsu's face, he's really in pain right now. Sharp really putting the pressure on the nerve.
That's one way to escape. Yatsu. Blocking Sharp drop kick. Good, he's getting himself up now. Sharp is quick and very, very clever. Good sized shoulders and chest on Yoshiaki Yatsu. Cover now. And a kick out.
I tell you what, Vince, I'm very, very impressed with Yatsu. For a man that's been professional wrestling for only 3.5 months. And I tell you what, I'm very, very impressed.
Well, Pat, as a matter of fact, you've had an occasion to help Mr. Yatsu from time to time, have you not, in terms of his training?
With my busy schedule and the little bit of time that I have that free, and I really go out of my way to really try to help him, because he's really determined. He's a real, real nice kid. And of course, with his amateur background, he's got everything going for him.
Very eager young man to learn everything that he possibly can, is he not?
Oh, he is, Vince. He works very hard, trains very hard. Just a young man who is about 245 pounds, trains every day, really determined.
Sharp has been devastating with the elbow smashes. And Yatsu has been on the receiving end of most of the punishment here.
Now, if Yatsu would just roll out of the ring for a while and take a 7 or 8 count, would do him a lot of good, but he doesn't know that.
That'll all come with experience, Pat.
Yes.
Oh.
I suspect that was a time limit. Pretty boy with a smile on his face. He's a tough competitor. Yatsu wants to have a little more time here.
Wrestling fans, that bout went to the 10-minute time limit. The official decision, a draw.
Yatsu and Sharp Wrestling to a draw. We'll be back in a moment. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest now, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling, along with Sergeant Slaughter. And wherever Mr. Slaughter appears, certainly there are many, many signs about the arenas. We have one here. If I may, I'll be glad to hold it.
I'll hold it for you.
Sergeant is number one. However,
there
is also a cute little sign here on the other side, and it's from one of the fans. And look at Sergeant Slaughter, a caricature of Slaughter in the...
Get that out of here! Get that!
You object to the signs about the arenas, do you?
I certainly do. Like I said before, all you maggots, you listen up right now.
You object to what you hear now?
No, I don't like that. I don't like that. That's disrespectful. Respect your sergeant. Respect your sergeant. Don't call me Gomer. That's disrespectful. When you're in the boot camp and you can't do anything right, you're called a Gomer. Do I look like a Gomer pile? Do I? I can't hear you. I have been around here now for about 6 to 8 months. When I came in here, the name Sergeant Slaughter was only in the ears of some recruits, some former recruits that were in my boot camp. But now the word Sergeant Slaughter is a household name. People are naming their children Sergeant Slaughter. People are going around the country with Sergeant Slaughter shirts, Sergeant Slaughter banners saying I'm number one. And that's what I want to see, not Gomer Pyle signs. I don't want to be called a Gomer Pyle. It's disrespectful. You have to have respect for the general and I. I don't want to see, and I hear there's a rumor. I heard a rumor that anywhere I appear, any arena that I go in, if someone brings the biggest sign of a Gomer Pyle, they get free tickets to the matches. Do you understand? That's a conspiracy. They're giving 2 free tickets to the biggest Gomer sign in any arena I appear in. No, I don't think that's just right. Do you? Do you? I can't hear you, maggot. I can't hear you, maggot.
It is indeed disrespectful, but McMahon, the signs don't wrestle, and the signs can't beat Sergeant Slaughter, and the $10,000 is still intact. Nobody has been able to get out of the Cobra Clutch once the sergeant has applied it. We still have our money, and a lot of guys are walking around with their necks like this. That's what's going on, and we demand respect for this man because he deserves it.
You know, when I come out in the arenas and I hear Gomer Pyle, it's not fair. My opponents have the advantage because all I hear is Gomer Pyle. People throw things and they hit innocent fans like you. You think that's right? You think that's right? I don't want anybody out there ever again. If I hear it once, that's it. I'll leave this area if I keep hearing Gomer Pyle. I'll leave. Shut up.
Well, you may have some control over our opponents, but you have no control at all over the fans here, all over the World Wrestling Federation.
If we had control, the first thing we'd do is give them all baths because they sure can use it.
I'm right now going on record, and I'm challenging anyone, any wrestler. That goes for Bruno Sammartino. Bob Backlund, you're the great champion. Why don't you come out? How about you, Pedro Morales, the Moondogs?
Yellow Belly.
All of them. I don't care about who it is. Gorilla Monsoon, and I'll even take you on. Would you like to pay $10,000? Maybe I should put it on you right now.
I don't think we need any demonstration of that nature. Thank you very much. You get a kick out of that, would you, Grandmother?
I enjoy it. Just the thought of the sergeant putting that hold on you thrills me from the top of my head to the bottom of my toes. Because if ever a man deserved the Cobra Clutch, it's you.
Sergeant Slaughter and the General are declaring war on wrestlers, and we're not taking any prisoners.
Right.
You're dismissed out there.
All right, Sergeant Slaughter.
And you're dismissed.
This contest is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager of champions, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. And now the participants. In the corner to my right, from Dawson, Georgia, weighing 234 pounds, Charlie Brown. And his opponent from South Carolina, 292 pounds, Sergeant Slaughter.
Sergeant Slaughter against Charlie Brown. Here we go. Sergeant Slaughter with the salute to the Grand Wizard. The Wizard's not just your average five-star general. He's a six-star general, Pat.
Well, that is, he calls himself a six-star general. I'd like to call him something else myself. It's something that I could not mention on television.
Sergeant Slaughter, one of the roughest, toughest individuals ever in the World Wrestling Federation. And Pat, you know firsthand just how rough and rugged this man is.
I know indeed, Vince. He is a rough man. He is strong. He knows everything there is to know in wrestling.
And Charlie Brown, finding out just how tough and rough Sergeant Slaughter can be.
Well, Vince, I guess he still is challenging everybody for $5,000 for the Cobra Clutch. But as far as I'm concerned, Vince, I did get out of the Cobra Clutch. I didn't get the money, so he's still challenging.
Slaughter rams the knee to the throat. Listen to these fans picking up the chant. If they yell long enough and loud enough, that'll get to him, won't it, Pat?
Oh, it does. It really gets to him. He gets really, really upset. And I tell you, Vince, Slaughter is the type of man that just loves to punish his opponent. I mean, a lot of time he could just pick him up and slam him and pin him, period. But no, it's not enough for Sergeant Slaughter. Just loves to punish his opponent.
Ooh, hard forearm smash to the chest. Another one. Slaughter laying him in on Charlie Brown, knocking him right down to the canvas. Can you imagine what he, you see what he does to professional wrestlers, even the inexperienced ones, but can you imagine what Slaughter did to those poor young recruits? 140-pound, 50, 60-pound recruit. Can you imagine what delight he had in punishing those young men?
There's no telling what he did, Vince. There's no telling.
Slaughter with that protruding jaw of his.
that's one job that I would like to see disappeared, I'll tell you.
Slaughter sending Charlie Brown to the rope. Whoa. Charlie Brown on the receiving end of the Cobra Clutch. You can see it coming, setting him up with it. The referee wasted no time at all, nor did the wrestler Charlie Brown in submitting. Referee wasting no time in having the bell run, because that can be a very dangerous, dangerous hold if applied for any length of time at all.
The time of the match, 4 minutes, 10 seconds. The winner with the Cobra Clutch, Sergeant Slaughter.
Sergeant Slaughter victorious. We go now to some slow motion action. Slaughter and Brown drove that man down to the cat. And now Slaughter picking Charlie Brown up, setting him up now for the Cobra Clutch. A whip now to the rope. Coming out. Brown can now place the Cobra Clutch at 5. Slaughter on to yet another victory. We'll be back with Pedro Morales, King Kong Mosca, and more.
The next match is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing to my left, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 239 pounds, the unpredictable Johnny Raz. And his opponent, hailing from Culebra, Puerto Rico. He weighs 241 pounds. He is the current Intercontinental Champion, Pedro Morales.
Pedro, taking on Johnny Raz. A little handshake. Very, very friendly surge is Pedro Morales, especially outside the squared circle. When the bell rings, as it has, though, he's all business then. Backing Rods off now.
Well, you know, Vince, Pedro always says he liked to wrestle the rough guys, the big guys, the strong guys. Well, he's got somebody in that ring this week by the name of Johnny Rods. Unpredictable Johnny Rods. He's gonna have his hands full, there's no questions about it.
Morales trying to get Rods up. Has him up now. Down across the knee, and certainly breaks the hole.
Pedro Morales, former world's champion. He has fought really some of the best wrestlers in the world today. And now the Intercontinental Champion, he is still fighting the best.
Favoring a left knee a bit. Mr. Rods may have been fooling around, tampering a bit with the buckle covering. Certainly doing a little bit more than just checking things out over there, I'm sure of that.
You know, Vince, what a lot of young wrestlers don't do today, it's very important before you go into the ring to really have to psych yourself. No matter who you're wrestling, before you go into the ring, take 15, 20 minutes, and you really psych yourself before you go into the ring. And that's one thing that Pedro Morales does every night. Myself, I do.
Well, you saw what happened earlier with Jim Blotz loosening up the buckle cuff, ripped it off. Morales went head first to that steel ring. Rods are going to send him in there again. Let's up the buckle. Pedro breaking his face, trying to turn it around for himself.
Johnny Rods gave him the right name.
Rods in great condition, always. Trains hard on the mat, in the gym. He's a dedicated professional, Johnny Rods. And I don't know if you know him or not, Pat, outside the square circle, but he's not a bad guy at all outside.
Well, Vince, to be really truthful with you, I have no idea what kind of man he is outside of the ring.
Seems to be a gentleman. Something less than a gentleman in that square circle, though.
Oh, at times he could be a gentleman in the ring.
Pedro off the rope. Nice spot. Morales trying again as Rods is getting up. Small pockets.
in Spanish, Fantastico, Pedro.
The time of the match, 7 minutes, 31 seconds, and your winner, the Intercontinental Champion, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales, in the non-title event, victorious over Johnny Ross. And you wonder just how long Pedro will continue to reign as the Intercontinental Champion. Look at Pedro now. Ross wants some more, he'll give him some more. Let's go to slow motion action now. We saw in the latter stage of the match, Pedro and Johnny Rods. The whip to the ropes. Pedro setting him up. Back body drop. That really took its toll on Johnny Rods. Not just on a temporary basis, but on a long-term basis. Back injury is very, very prevalent in pro wrestling. That's one of the reasons why. Then from there, Rods trying to set Morales up for the back body drop and return to favor. Pedro, and there, look at the ankle hooking the right leg of Rods. The left leg hooked around underneath the knee by Pedro Morales with his right hand. He really had him hooked. Pedro on to victory. We'll be back as we continue, ladies and gentlemen, with a one-of-a-kind indeed by the name of King Kong.
The next match is set for one fall to the curfew. Introducing first the manager, Captain Louis Albano. And now the participants. In the corner to my right, from Lyndhurst, New Jersey, weighing 230 pounds, Jerry Johnson. And his opponent, 319 pounds, from Toronto, Canada, King Kong Maska.
King Kong against Jerry Johnson. Here we go. King Kong Maska having no problem thus far with Jerry Johnson. Maska's so strong, and we'll talk about rugged. They don't come any more rugged than this one, do they, Pat?
Well, he's just about a giant. He's a very, very rugged man, and when he really wants to get down and dirty, I guarantee you, all hell breaks loose.
Pat, you were relating a story that recently when you saw Mr. Maska in a matchup in Canada, when he really became incensed, when he really became angry, and when he becomes angry, he is a totally different individual, isn't he?
Vince, it's an ugly sight to see, really, because it takes more than one man to really stop him. Look at the size of him, the legs, the size of his leg, the size of his shoulder. He's just a big, big man. And when he goes wild, I mean, it takes more than one man to stop him. Actually, you're watching him on television right now. Believe you me, he is being very, very mild.
Goofy Albano looking on, enjoying what's happening in the square. Ooh, wow. You can see Jerry Johnson's body jar from the forearm smash into the back area.
Maska yelling at Johnson, come on, Backlund, get up. Come on, Bruno, get up. But I'll guarantee you, he won't have to yell that at Bruno or Backlund or anybody else.
Johnson across that knee. Backbreaker fashion. Shuts him up like so much garbage and pours it on a little bit. Look at Mosca looking at some of the fans now with great disdain. He does anything he pleases, according to Mr. Mosca.
The time of the match, 3:04, and your winner, King Kong Mosca.
King Kong Mosca, victorious over Jerry Johnson. Apparently he's not finished with it. Ooh.